Yo guys, and welcome back to the FIFA 20 Sunderland career mode. So we are now in episode 27 and we have Portsmouth in our next game in the, I'm pretty sure it's the Carabao Cup fourth round. Yes it is, because it says on the screen. Well done, Talon. You know, I'm retarded, okay? Just let me have that. Anyway, yeah, we have Portsmouth who are in League One. I did a little bit of digging in my save file and discovered that Portsmouth were still in League One. So we have Portsmouth in the Carabao Cup in this episode. I'm pretty sure we've got a couple of Premier League games as well as a Champions League tie. So going into the Premier League, as you can see, we are mid-table-ish. Starting in 13th place in this episode, hopefully we can get some points on the board. Going into the Champions League, and as you can see, we are second in our group. We need to win our next two games if we want to get into the knockout rounds. So tough times ahead, but let's get into the Portsmouth game, guys. And we'll see what we can do against them. All right, guys, so Portsmouth right now. Portsmouth game, I'm starting with the second team as the first team is still recovering from their previous game. So, yeah, Portsmouth League One side against our more or less Premier League side. I'm sort of hoping, you know, I'm sort of aiming for a victory here. It should be a marginal difficulty as well, you know, 3-4-0. So yeah, like I say, let's get into it. All right, and kickoff has begun. And as I said, we're looking for, you know, like a pretty big victory here. You know, Portsmouth shouldn't really be any trouble, not to us really. Also not wearing a hat in this episode because I, you know, I don't need it anymore. My hair has grown back to a sufficient point. So yeah, we're just looking for an opening here. Kim Yoka down the right hand side. What can he do? He's going to get on the outside. He's going to jink back in. It's Karamoko Dembele. That's a pen. That is big pen. That is big pen. Thank you very much, Christian Burgess. You are a dickhead, sir. Karamoko Dembele. What can Karamoko Dembele do? It's a solid pen. It's a solid pen from Karamoko Dembele. It is 1-0 already, 6 minutes gone. Nothing else I can see, really. Christian Burgess giving away the pen there. Just solid pen. Kimpe Yoko wins that ahead of Jordan Hunter. Mumba down the line. Kimpe Yoko down the line again for Frimpong. Good, good player. That's another pen. That's another pen. Surely. Oh, it was on the edge of the box. All right. Kim Yoga. Boom. Oh, it's come off Naylor. It's come off Naylor. It might actually be an own goal, but it's Bali Mumba's finish or shot that ends up in the back of the net. Good little quick work free kick there. I was trying to figure out what was going on. Hence why I didn't really commentate that much. But, you know, Kimpe Yoko coming close there. Gets it in, like, sort of lays it off on Mumba. Mumba, actually, that might be Bali Mumba's goal. It is. It is a Bali Mumba goal. Let's go. Karamoko Dembele. Dembele, you know, with the agility to get past his man. Gets it into Kimpe Yoko. It's come off Pardo. We do get a second bite at the cherry, though, with this corner. It's in towards Connolly. I'm not going to lie, lads. Connolly has actually been absolutely terrible for us. You know, for being a striker, he has not really lived up to the expectations that we needed him to. You know, his performances have been absolutely dire. I'm actually going to take him off because I really don't like Connolly. I am just going to bring on... I don't even have Stahl on the bench. Why don't I have Stahl on the bench? Anyway, I'll just bring on Greenwood. Because, yeah, I think I'm going to rotate Connolly out. I think I'm going to bring one of my youngsters through who I have in the youth academy right now. He's about 68 rated. So I think I'm going to bring him through. And, yeah, we're just going to use him instead of Connolly. Because, like I say, Connolly is pretty bad. Portsmouth down this left-hand side with Harrison into Hunter. Tries to get it off to Josephine, but Williams with the very calm defending there. Ruben Samut. I was going to say Ruben Samut to switch the player. Mason Greenwood through the middle. Mason Greenwood to sweat it into Dembele for 3-0. That is what we like. That is exactly the kind of shenanigans that we like in this series, ladies and gentlemen. Very good play. That's the 3-goal margin that I was kind of hoping for. I was hoping for a 3 or 4-0, which I do believe I said at the start of this match. But yeah, that is their 3-0 victory. Connolly, like I say, Connolly should have had at least 3 or 4 goals if he'd actually, you know, been a bit more clinical. But like I say, it's just one of them things, lads. It's just one of them things. And if I'm being honest, Connolly's getting rotated out. We're going to bring in our youth striker. I'm pretty sure he's Egyptian, if I remember correctly. So we will see about that. But in the meantime, we have a Portsmouth attack to save off. That's a fantastic save by Bazunu. They have a corner with Josephoon. That's crossed in. Kim Yorker deals with that. That's De Silva. That's Hunter. That's Tanganga. That's Bali Mumba. That's Josh Onuma. Onuma up the field. Karamoko Dembele straight through the middle. Karamoko Dembele with a big touch. Didn't need to do it, but it's full time. Ladies and gentlemen, we have beaten Portsmouth 3-0. Pretty sure your man of the match is Karamoko Dembele, but we'll quickly have a look and see if we want to get through the menus. Karamoko Dembele, 9.4 rating. Mason Greenwood there with an 8.7. Despite being on the field only about 20 minutes or 25 minutes, Mason Greenwood there with an 8.7. Kim Yorker, 9.1. Really good performance there from him. 9.3 as well from Bali Mumba. Absolutely fantastic performance in the middle of midfield, on the defence, on the attack, everything as such, getting himself a goal as well. Alright guys, and here we have Mohamed Hassan. He is our youth academy striker. He is the one that is going to be replacing Connolly in the second team, at least for now. So he is 71 rated, and as you can see, he has 11 traits. He has 11 traits from my youth academy, bro. Anyway, he is 6'8", right? He's 6'8". He is high-low, and he has 97 pace. He's 6'8", he's rapid as football. Anyway, 74 dribbling, which isn't bad. Bear in mind, dribbling is made up of ball control, dribbling, agility, balance, all that shit. Alright, free kick accuracy, etc. Passing, 64 there, 66 shooting, 86 physical, that's strength and aggression. His stamina isn't exactly very good, but his strength, I think he's got like 90 strength and about 83 aggression, so something like that. And obviously 18 defending there, so he's okay. He's 71 rated. He is gonna grow. But yeah, I'm looking forward to seeing how he plays in game, and yeah, we'll just see how that goes. I think I might actually bring him on against Norwich in the second half and just see what he can do. And speaking of Norwich City, ladies and gentlemen, here we have Carroll Road. So away game in the Premier League, going with the first team again. Going back to what I was just saying, the new kid, Hassan, he will be in the second team. He's on the bench right now, and he will be brought on in the second half. So yeah, Norwich away from home. Should be good. All right, lads, so half an hour of the game has passed, and we haven't even had a shot. We genuinely haven't even had a shot yet. Norwich has had like one or two. They're playing some beautiful football right now. Malanda got an interception. But when we get to this part of the field, there's just no one, like, up, if that makes sense. I'm just going to sweat this because I want the goal. But when we get to, like, the front end of the pitch, there's literally no support for Stahl or Greenwood. And they've got to sort of try and go alone against two or three defenders. Now, we did get lucky there. Good, like, you know, good burst of pace there from Lucas Stahl to get ahead of his man. But at the same time, again, we've been lackluster in this match. We've been very, very lethargic in this match. And against the rubber, the green, we are 1-0 up. Alright guys, the second half has begun, and Lucas Stahl did pick up a yellow card in the first half for a little bit of a meaty challenge. So I'm just going to try. Oh, that was unlucky there. Obviously you can see Hassan on the pitch, like, he's fucking huge, you can't miss him. You legit cannot miss Mohamed Hassan. Like, you really, really can't. Anyway, Tito Fernandez to pick this up gives it straight back to Stieperman. Like, Pookie with a couple of step overs gets away from Ayoma, but Ayoma, good tackle. Like, yeah, like, you can't really miss Hassan. Hassan is straight through, though. Mohamed Hassan! Ah, that was his chance. He doesn't exactly have the best of finishing stats, but that was his chance to get a goal on his debut for the club. I want him to get a goal, bro. I want him to get that debut goal. Good tackle, Ayoma. Max Ahrens. Straight through for Mason Greenwood, hopefully. Greenwood does pick this up. Greenwood across the face of box. It's Hassan with his debut goal. That's Mohamed Salah's face. What? Why has a randomly generated... You know what? Realism mod, I think. We have Mohamed Salah. No, it's Mohamed Hassan, all right? It's Mohamed Hassan. All right, anyway, Mohamed Hassan has a goal on his debut. It is a beautiful finish into the goal. He has for some reason, Mohamed Salah's face. But, you know what? I don't care. Right? I really, really don't care. We have a new striker in town, and he's just scored... He scored more goals this season than Aaron Connolly. Malanda, too bloody late. Malanda, you're pissing me off. Pookie into Stieperman. Saw that coming a mile off. Too many misplaced passes in the middle of midfield. Junior Malanda giving the ball away far, far, far too much. Everyone's being so lethargic right now, and I don't know why. Like, my players are not, you know, performing to the standard that they should be. Amuzu, what the fuck are you doing? Like, my players are not performing to the levels that they should be. Junior Malanda's taking far too long on the ball when, you know, I'm pressing pass, and he's taking, like, two or three touches before he actually, you know, passes the ball. So, it's, you know, slightly annoying and disappointing to see that my team are being very, very lackluster right now on the pitch, and Norwich are coming forward yet again. I was picking you down this left-hand side into Pookie, into John Tribal, into Pookie. Oh my god, we're not conceding again. We are not going down this road again. Yes, we are. Yes, we are. Yep, yes, we are. Stieperman into Pookie. Pookie's going to shoot and score. Get this fucking clear, will you? Jesus Christ, actually do something. Hassan into Greenwood. Into Hassan. Good save, Tim Krul. I don't know why I said Tom there. Adnan Januzaj though to flick this in. It's Tito Fernandez. It's off the head of Tito Fernandez. Was that a push? Max Ahrens. That's come off Hassan's head because Hassan's 6'8". This is a very long highlight. I do apologize, lads. But yeah. Team is performing very, very poor. Why is that pass going there? What are you doing? What are you doing? What the fuck are you doing? You know what? This is just going to be unedited. This is just going to be unedited because it's the end of the match. There we go. It's a 2-1 victory, but at the same time, holy shit. Unnecessary pass, unnecessary misplaced passing. And you know what? Ugh, stressful win. But we won anyway. We actually did manage to pull off a victory. Mohamed Hassan got banned the match. What a debut performance with an 8.4 rating for Mohamed Hassan. What a guy. Alright, match number 3. Again, we're having a third match in this episode because we have Real Madrid in the Champions League and I can't afford to lose this. So, going with the second team, as the first team is still kind of tired. Going with the second team, Mohamed Hassan gets his Champions League debut. Hopefully, he can get a Champions League goal as well. Karamoko Dembele there starts behind him, so that's good support for him. Tanganga and Herve is our centre-backs. Nothing else much needs to be said. Let's just jump straight into this and get started. Frimpong, good header away. Onoma into Samud. Samud brings it away. Karamoko Dembele into Hassan, into Samut. Ruben Samut, of all people, Ruben Samut! It's 1-0, we've took the lead! Let's go! Hassan getting an assist there. Again, I'm never going to get used to the fact that he's got Mohamed Salah's face, but whatever. Hassan gets his assist, and it's into Ruben Samut, who puts this past Thibaut Courtois into the back of the net, into the bottom corner, in it, like, bruv, in it. Ah, we took the lead again. Hopefully we can fucking hold on to this time. Brandon Williams. In behind for Mohamed Hassan. It's 2-0. Let's go. Hassan gets his debut, Champions League debut goal. It was a bit of a finish to begin with. But if I'm being honest, not. He's done well. He has done well there to get in behind the defence. Good through there. Good through ball by Brandon Williams to get in behind. I think that was Carvajal or Ramos. Again, comes off Courtois, gets a second chance, and puts it in the back of the net. I really don't like how FIFA tries to predict where you want to pass the ball instead of actually just passing it in the direction that you're pointing. Like, it's really, really frustrating to play this game. Really, really frustrating. Either way, Brandon Williams, good tackle. Into Mohamed Hassan, into Karamoko Dembele, into Bali Mumba. This is really good play. Bali Mumba, that's three. Good, good play. We've got Manchester City next, and I need to sim it.
Yay, we're going to get smashed.
Either way, Bali Mumba. Bali Mumba. Real Madrid are getting absolutely torn apart right now. Very good counter-attack by the boys. Bali Mumba, a good finish into the bottom corner. Thibaut Courtois stood no chance with that finish. It's three. Up to Josh Onuma, who's got Brandon Williams for company, but he finds Karamoko. That's a free kick. I was going to say that he finds Karamoko Dembele. Now, I need a left footer on this. You know what? We're going to give it to Mohamed Hassan. Because why not? He's going to just put it here with some curve. Oh, it's off the bar! Oh my god! If that was a fraction lower, that was in the back of the net. It's Onuma with the shot. He finds the back of the net. It's four. Good finish, Josh Onuma. Good finish. But we... Oh my god. I can't believe Hassan just hit the bar. Bro. Oh my god. I need to replay that free kick. Alright lads, so I'm in replay mode, and here we have Hassan's free kick. He just sort of, you know, it's a really good side sort of run up, and like, it's, oh, it was saved by Courtois. It was actually saved by Courtois. It was going in. He saves it onto the bar and then out off the post. Oh my word. Alright guys, so 5 minutes of the game left to go, and it's been an absolutely incredible performance. Absolutely dominating performance from this rotation team right now. Mohamed Hassan has played really, really well. He's fit into the team nicely. Frimpong's just picked this up. Mohamed Hassan. It's actually five. He's cheekily rolled that past Courtois. Like, he just runs, stops and goes, yeet. Oh my god, Hassan could have had a hat-trick. He could have legit had a hat-trick. Like, either way, lads, Hassan has played absolutely incredible. Gets two goals. Could have had, obviously, the third with a hat-trick if Courtois hadn't saved that. So it could have actually been 6-0. Obviously, Ruben Samut getting a goal. I'm not quite sure. I can't remember who the others were. I know that Mumba got one. But if I'm being, like I say, lads, if I'm being brutally honest, we've played really, really well. Like, 5-0 against Real Madrid. Cannot complain. We are now on 8 points in our group. We just need to win our last game. or one of our two remaining games against Shakhtar or PSG, and hopefully we can do well. Look at that domination. Look at the domination there. One shot only for Real Madrid. Nine shots, eight on target for us. Absolutely dominant performance. Mohamed Hassan there, man of the match. Again, two man of the matches in a row, two games played. Absolutely phenomenal little player, 71 rated. No, again, he is automatically generated by the game. I think the realism mod has sort of give him Mohamed Salah's face. Don't know why, but there we go. It's Mohamed Salah in disguise. All right, and just to ride the Mohamed Hassan hype train, he's been called up for Egypt. As you can see, we have several players leaving on international duty. Brandon Williams, Max Aarons and Karim Okwudambela there for England, and Adan Yanezai for Belgium, Ruben Samud for Scotland, Gavin Bazunu and Aaron Connolly for Ireland, Jeremy Frimpong for the Netherlands and Benjamin Kimpyok there for Sweden, and obviously Mohamed Hassan for Egypt. But yeah, just to ride the hype train a little bit more, guys, Hassan has been called up for international duty. So he's 16-year-old, lads. He's played technically three games for us. No, he hasn't. He's played two. He started and he come on as a sub. So he's made two appearances and he's already got an international call-up. I think we have a new talisman in this game. All right, guys, and now comes the difficult game of Manchester City at home. Sorry, we're going with the first team, and we are going to go ahead and hit advance on this one. Then we're going to hit skip. It's a 3-0 victory! Yes! It's a 3-0 victory against Manchester City. It's the Yanezai, Stahl and Onoma who get the goals. That has absolutely baffled me. We've actually got three points from Manchester City. Let's go! Yes! All right, guys, and here we have the last sim game of this episode. It is Wolverhampton Wanderers at Molineux. So we're going to go ahead and advance, and we are skipping. And it's a 2-1 defeat. That looks like Dimitri Payet there for Wolves, which is not what we wanted. Aaron Connolly there picking up an injury, but I doubt it's serious. Lucas Stahl there getting our goal, though. And yeah, we'll just take it from there, I guess. That's, you know, 3-0 win against Manchester City and then a 2-1 defeat at Wolves. It's all right, don't get me wrong. We can take it on the chin. All right, guys, so rounding off this episode, we sit second in our Champions League group, 2 points behind Paris Saint-Germain, who we have next. That is going to be the first game of the next episode, ladies and gentlemen. So, yeah, Paris Saint-Germain is currently unbeaten, the same as us in our Champions League group. The last time we played Paris Saint-Germain, last episode I think it was, we drew against them 1-1. So we are hoping for 3 points here so we can obviously try and finish top of our group, as we'll have Shakhtar Donetsk after that. Shakhtar Donetsk there haven't won a single game this Champions League campaign, which is disappointing for them. You know, they are a decent little team, but obviously, like I say, they haven't won a game this group. So yeah, it looks like they're gonna maybe drop out of the competition altogether. They'll completely bypass the Europa League as well and just go straight out of Europe. If I just have a quick look at the other groups as well, Chelsea and Barcelona there, looks like they've definitely qualified for their group. Looks like Spurs, Bayern and Ajax still could qualify yet. Valencia and Juventus have qualified from their groups straight away. Liverpool and Napoli there have both qualified from their groups. That's a tight little group there. Olympic Lyon, Dortmund and Inter Milan there could still qualify from Group F. Group G there, again, Leipzig, City and Milan all kind of tied there for the lead. It's all in the balance, and Leverkusen and Atletico Madrid have definitely qualified from their group. So yeah, moving into the Premier League, let's just jump straight into let's finish off this episode. We've climbed up to 11th place in the table. We started off in 13th, where Watford is now, and we've climbed up to 11th. So realistically speaking, we are mid-table. We are happy where I am right now in the table. As that, you know, that is our that is our season objective this season, to finish mid-table in the Prem. So if I can finish, you know, 10th to 12th, you know, I'm happy with that. The board should be satisfied as well. Again, nothing really to worry about. Liverpool are currently top of the Premier League, followed closely by Spurs, Manchester United there, and Arsenal and Chelsea. You know, 27, 28, 29, 30, and 31 points respectively. Brighton there, still in the top six, just in front of Manchester City, who sit in seventh. But yeah, we are sitting comfortably. I say comfortably, we are sitting okay, you know, in 11th place there. If we move into the Carabao Cup, the quarterfinals, we have Leeds United. So we've been given a really, really nice draw there in the Carabao Cup as well. So we're starting to get at the business end of this competition right now. Obviously Leeds are the only championship side, or the Football League side left in... No, wait, Leeds are in the Prem. Hang on. Are Leeds in the Prem? No, I'm getting myself confused. All right, so we do have Leeds then in... So they are Football League side. So yeah, we've got them. They're the only Football League side left in the Carabao Cup. Wolves, Everton, good little fixture there. Manchester United, Arsenal, really good fixture. And obviously Spurs should be Brighton. And then obviously we'll get a really big team in the semi-finals of that competition. So I'm going to leave the episode there, ladies and gentlemen. Like I said, things are going well. I think we found a new talisman. I honestly think we have found a new talisman. I will leave the Premier League table up for you. So like I say, thanks for watching, guys. If you have enjoyed this episode, drop a thumbs up. It would be greatly appreciated. If you are new around here, hit that subscribe button and the notifications icon so you know when I release new content or go live. Let me know what you think of the series and what you think of Mohamed Hassan in the comment section down below. It would be great to hear from you guys. And yeah, like I say, thanks for watching, and I'll catch you in a bit.